Joanne. There should be papers on this chair.
Oh, yeah.
So, we talked about one way to connect, right? Let's ask our spouses what do they like hearing, what do they like, and so we're talking about our verbal. Well, we're going to move into a new exercise, and this is something that O'Leary and I discovered 12 years ago, quite by accident, and it absolutely revolutionized the way we interact with each other. We actually identified and resolved an issue that had been in our marriage for 12 years, and all of a sudden, poof.
Wow.
It was absolutely resolved, and it hasn't been an issue since. And this is about the five senses. So I was reading, anyone here like a kind of a, you know, would-be interior decorator? All right. So I was going through this phase a number of years ago where I was loving, you know, building our home, decorating, you know, reading a bunch of interior decorating books. And they were suggesting that you decorate your home to suit all the five senses.
Amen.
Well, most of the time you're thinking, hey, this is a visual thing, right? Mm-hmm. But they were talking about, you know, what are the aromas, what are the sounds, and what are the touches, you know? Mm-hmm. And so I was starting to think about this. At the same time, O'Leary had just gone off to a 4-day, very rigorous workshop, and he got an assignment. And you want to share about that assignment?
And so this is all open. Part of it was with 50 people, and a lot of egos were like plastered. You know, blood was dripping off the walls because our egos were getting slaughtered. But one of the exercises is to that the person you struggle with the most, you go and talk with. You know, because isn't that where all the access is? You know, mm-hmm. It's like. And so the question was, you know, the assignment was for the next 5 minutes, go to the person that you're least attracted to. Mm. Mm-hmm. And I'm going like, oh yeah, right, you know, like that. And then I go like, well, wait a minute, you know, we've been here 2 hours and only 4 people have spoken. I haven't heard everybody speak, so I can't really know. And at that moment, I realize, oh my gosh, I'm auditory centered. That is my major sense. And of course, a woman who was visually centered was dragging her chair toward me, and I go, oh my God, not her! We became really good friends after that.
So, when he was sharing his experience at this workshop, and he was auditory, and I all of a sudden realized, okay, I'm thinking about how do I design the home for five senses, including his preferences, and I am completely visually centered. Mm. And so the way things look is the most important thing to me. Mm. So all of a sudden we started having a very interesting conversation. So one of the things that had been a bugaboo in our marriage is the kitchen looks like a mess. I want it cleaned up, you know, there's like dishes all over the place, and it was visual clutter, and I just was going crazy. So I would want to clean it up. Well, he was very irritated by the fact I was making all this noise in the evening or in the early morning.
6 a.m.
You know, wherever it was. And so at that moment, I realized we got talking about this visual, I want a clean-looking kitchen, versus auditory, he wants a peaceful environment, right? So we started talking about it, and I found out, first of all, his ears are very sensitive to the clinking and clanging and banging, and, you know, I mean, that's just really loud. And also, he had had, you know, his mom, his bedroom was next to the kitchen, and his mom used to clean up the kitchen while he's waking up or still sleeping, right? So he's got a couple of things working against him on that. And all of a sudden, I had compassion. Mm. You know, I understood my man a little bit more. And I go, okay, it's not that he's fighting against me. It's that he's got a preference and it's built on something. And all of a sudden I had compassion. And since then, if I want to have a clean kitchen, I'll either, you know, clean up when he's not there, we'll do it together, or I'll ask his permission so that he can be prepared. And it has worked out really good since then. And all of a sudden, that particular one got resolved in a moment.
Wow.
So we knew we had something there. Mm-hmm. So now we're going to take a minute. Now I want you to be thinking in your head. This is an individual exercise. You're going to think, what is the most important sense to you? What's the one that kind of drives you around the world? If all the other ones were gone and you could only pick one to exist by, which one would it be? And so I'm going to have you take a minute to write that down, a few moments to write it down, and then we're going to come back together. We're going to do some sharing and some other things. So just for now, we're going to have you fill out your chart for the first one. What is your